I was, I think, 22 years old when I was walking down the staircase and I had a whole bunch of relatives assembled at the bottom. And I remember one of them telling my mom, you know, what, even if she gets cured, what are you going to do next? How are you going to handle it, et cetera, et cetera. I remember turning around and telling her, don't worry, aunt, I'm going to be on the cover of Forbes in 5 years from now and I'll kill it. So don't worry about what happens next. I had no clue how that's going to happen. I had no clue how you got onto the cover of Forbes or into the cover of Forbes or how you could actually go about building a business. But what I did have was an unnerving faith in myself that I will do it. 5 years later, I remember waking up in on January 2016 and thinking, oh, you know, I made this really tall promise to my mother and it's not happened yet. What the hell, everyone's going to laugh at me. And I remember my aunt smirking at me and, you know, thinking I'm going a little cuckoo. Then I called up my mom. I was in Vizag, I think. And I said, I'm so sorry, you know, I'd made this promise. I don't think I'm going to be able to keep up to the promise. And my mom laughed and she's like, dude, you really think we care? It doesn't matter. I don't even remember you making such a promise. I was like, whatever. You know, a couple of months passed by and I remember on March 21st, 2016, I got a call from Forbes saying that you're on the Forbes 30 under 30 list and we want you to come down here for a shoot, et cetera, et cetera. This was about 6 days short of the promise I'd made to my mom on March 26, 2011. And I started pinching myself and I was like, is this really real? You know, are you sure this was a real call? Was this a real number? Is this really happening? And it just taught me one thing, that is, if you believe in yourself, the entire universe conspires to make everything possible for you. In those 5 years, what did we do to get on the lists and get on all these covers? I don't know. But what I do know is that, you know, every single day I would wake up and tell myself, we're going to do this, we're going to do this, we're going to overcome every single obstacle and we're going to continue changing the way the world flies. You know, when I started JetSetGo, it was from my bedroom. And I remember sitting on the dining table with my father and my father's brother and telling them, I'm going to do this and I'm going to raise so much money and I'm going to change this and I'm going to go here. And then my uncle looked at me and he was like, Kanika, why would anyone give you that kind of money? Or why would anyone think you're going to be able to fly these planes? You know, you're the small town girl from Bhopal. You've got these great dreams. It's great to dream. But, you know, think more real. Be more realistic. All this is great in storybooks. It's great in movies. But this is real life. And I remember thinking to myself that, you know, are you not allowed to dream? Are you not allowed to believe in yourself? What is this guy saying? And I got over it. But, you know, it kept coming back to my mind again and again. Every single time when someone said no, I would think, was this uncle right? When I went to make my first pitch for my business to this really huge organization, I remember walking into the boardroom. I was the last person to enter the boardroom. And the person we had gone to make a pitch to said, excuse me, miss, can you please ask everyone for what they want, tea or coffee? And I looked at him and I was like, now what do I say? And then I was like, I'm so sorry, but you know, I'm the CEO of the company who's come to make this pitch to you. And he really didn't know how to react. You know, I was like, oh, okay, yeah, I'm so sorry. I'll just be back. And he walked out of the meeting. I then had his CEO and other people, you know, spend some time with me, which looked like they were spending more time just to, like, you know, get the meeting go by because the chairman had walked out. You know, I made up my mind that I am going to win this pitch and I am going to close this business and he is going to be my customer. And I believed in myself. And we stalked them and stalked them and stalked them for 6 months until they gave us all their business. Today, the guy is our largest customer. You know, he's our largest believer. I think he talks about us to every single friend of ours. Because of us, his company, which had a 2.4% population of women working in them, now has over 17% women working in them because he now believes what women can do. But the one thing that keeps coming out was that I believed that we could go in and close the business. I believe we could go in and change the way things work. You know, I remember soon after that pitch walking into a government organization, a PSU, and telling them that all the money they're spending on these planes is all wrong and they need to change the way the government flies, they need to change the way their bills are paid. And this was in a country like India where everyone knows how government departments and organizations work. You know, and I walked in dressed like this, like I normally do, went and met a bunch of really old people who had been working there for 30, 35 years. And they were like, ma'am, you know, all your new age ideas, young ideas, I was, I think, 23 or 24 at that time, are great, but this is a government organization. This ain't going to fly here. And I remember sitting there and staring at him and saying, are you crazy? I'm telling you I can reduce your bill by 50% if you just get a little more organized and systematic. But you're trying to tell me that this is a government organization and you can't change things. We again worked our way up, went to various different departments, various different organizations within the PSU, and convinced them to change stuff, and convinced them to fly with us, convinced them to reduce their costs. And then I remember my CFO coming up to me and saying, ma'am, why would you unabashedly keep going after this so much when these guys had already said a no to you? And I said, if you don't believe in yourself and if you don't believe that you can change the way things work, no one else is going to believe in you, and you're not going to be able to make a better place out of this country or be able to do better business. When we went to get our first plane under JetSetGo, to build JetSetGo to actually achieve those goals in 5 years, the company we went to pitch to was one of India's largest infrastructure organizations. I remember sitting in front of the chairman, I was like 22 or 23, I think, and telling him, I can do this for you, I can do this for you, I can do this for you. You're doing this wrong, you're doing this wrong, you're doing this wrong. He heard me out, he gave me 4 hours instead of the 1 hour that his team had promised me. And then he said, I'll come back to you tomorrow. The next day we were called to present to the entire board. And I stood there in a room full of 18 men in suits looking at us very, very skeptically, like, are you guys serious? You're really going to change the way our planes fly? You're really going to fix maintenance issues? You're really going to decrease downtime? You're really going to decrease our costs? How are you possibly going to do this? I remember one of them saying, why aren't you married? Why aren't you focusing on getting married? Why don't you look at doing something easier, like, baking cupcakes or opening a boutique, etc., etc.? And, I stood there zapped, like, what the hell are we doing here? Are we really going to be trying to make it work with this organization? So we presented to the board and we walked out. And I could still hear outside the boardroom while the board members were discussing. And the chairman we'd gone to present to turned around. His whole board was against it. I could hear one of those guys saying, she's a very young girl. She doesn't know what she's saying. How is she going to do it? And the chairman of the particular business stood up and he said, the passion I saw in the girl's eyes and the faith I saw in the girl's eyes, I don't see it in any of yours. So I'm going to go ahead and give her this business. He was the first customer we closed, the first plane we got onto JetSetGo's platform, the first plane we took over to fly, re-engineer, maintain, manage, run, etc. And, from the first plane also came one more plane and one more plane from his company. So we took over 3 planes. And he gave me 3 months to turn things around. He said, look, I fought with the entire board. I fought with my entire family. And I'm giving you 3 months to prove what you're saying is right. When we took over the company was about losing about $1.8 million a month on an EBITDA level. So I'm not even going into net loss, etc. And in 90 days, they wanted me to turn it around, make it profitable, decrease downtime, improve maintenance, increase revenues, etc. So we ran it. And when I did the first team meeting with a team of people who were running these planes, I walked up to them and I said, guys, I need you all to believe in me. I need you all to support me. We need to do this together. We need to make your chairman proud and we need to make these planes run. I remember the entire team looking at me saying, you've really lost your marbles. This ain't going to work. And, I had to keep believing in myself. Every single night I would go back home crying at 2 a.m., 3 a.m. What have I gotten myself into? Is this going to work? Are we really going to change the way things work? And our own team would keep sabotaging us. There would be people, the pilots wouldn't turn up to fly the planes, the engineers won't turn up to clear the aircraft, because they didn't want us to succeed. They didn't want to change the way things work. They loved working in a very lethargic, easygoing way. And we were like, no, we're going to change this. We've got to get things going. 90 days later, we turned the company around. We gave them a $2.4 million profit per month as against the $1.8 million EBITDA loss they were doing on a monthly level. I think we fired 50% of the team who wasn't working. We made sure every single plane took off. We made sure every single plane landed. We made the company safer, faster, better, quicker. It wasn't the money that mattered. It was the faith that particular individual had in us, or had in me rather, to believe in me. I was a 4-people team working out of my bedroom, trying to change the faith of one of India's largest corporates, private aviation divisions. And that guy said, you had the faith in your eyes to deliver. And you've delivered. The same person who came up to me in the boardroom the first day and said, you should be going around doing something which is more girly and, open a boutique or something, came to me and said, Kanika, is it okay if my daughter, does an internship under you? I really want her to learn from you, etc., etc. So it was, these were Eureka moments for us, the smaller things. It wasn't about the money that you were earning or the fame that you were earning. It was about having that conviction in yourself that you can do what you really want to do. You can change what you really want to change and make things happen that got us going. From that first company, we got another company, another company, another company. You know, when I started the business, I didn't know how many zeros there were in a crore, to be very honest. Today, we do nine-digit businesses on a monthly turnover. We don't worry about... there was a time when, I remember when I started the business, on the 24th, I didn't know how our salaries were going to go. Miraculously, on the 29th, a big payment that was supposed to come in came in, and all our salaries were met. Today, we don't have to worry about, you know, such things about, oh, is this payment going to come? Are the salaries going to go, et cetera, et cetera. And I consistently ask myself, you know, what are we doing right? What are we doing to actually make this happen? And the answer that always comes out is that I have a team of people who believes in me. I believe in myself. I have a team of people who believes in themselves. I have a team of people who believes in the strength of the organization we've built. And they're never going to do anything to let us down. You know, in an interview 4 days back, someone asked me, you know, so Kanika, if you were given a magic wand and God allowed you to go back and change any three things in your life in the past 30 years that you've lived, what would the three things be? I'm someone who speaks very fast and always has answers and, you know, is always ready with answer to any interview question normally. This was the first time in my life that I actually sat there and I looked and I looked and I looked and I was like, what would I change? What would I change? What would I change? And even the interviewer was shocked because, you know, he couldn't write as fast as I was speaking earlier. And he said, are you serious? You don't have a response. So I said, look, hang on, I'm thinking, I'm actually thinking. And, you know, I thought a lot and there was absolutely nothing I would want to change because every adversity, everything that you've gone through, you know, from not having money to pay salaries, from not having money to pay rent, not knowing how tomorrow's planes are going to fly, it's taught us so much. It's made us the people who we are, that without every adversity, you would never have the courage to keep believing in yourself and keep inspiring others and keep moving ahead. So I turned around and I told him that, look, there's absolutely nothing I would like to change. And he was zapped. He said, why is that? You know, won't you want to not have been sick? Won't you want to have had all the money in the world when you started out? Won't you have had to had the power to do whatever you felt like? I said, look, I already have the power to do whatever I feel like because it's all here, number one. Number two, if I had all the money in the world to start the business when I wanted to, I probably wouldn't have been able to build this business. So every negative thing that's happened, every adversity that we've ever been hit by has always paved the way to greater opportunity, to greater success, to build what we are. And it's only one thing that always stands out during all of this, is that you have to keep believing in yourself and you have to keep going. If you believe in yourself, the entire universe conspires to make things happen for you and nothing can ever let you down. Thank you.